everybody. Today I'm going to be giving you a brief tutorial on how to manipulate layers inside the DSI Design Studio. So as you can see over on this left-hand function bar, I'm in my layers tab, and that opens up six different layers that we have here. Four images of a ship, one text layer, and one layer of a compass image. Before we get too deep into the weeds here, I do want to talk about the collaboration aspect of the Design Studio. Anytime you save a design to your designs, you are given a personal link to this design and all of the work that has been done on it, which means you can share that out with your design team and they can all open it up to contribute and collaborate on that flag set. So Jeff, Mike, Brent, and Danielle were all able to add an image of a ship that they thought would be best suited for this flag set. And now we can play around with and manipulate the layers to determine what that flag is going to look like. So the first function that I want to talk about is the visibility function. In this far left lane, you're going to see an eye icon. If you don't want to see Jeff's ship, you can simply click that and turn off the visibility on that layer. You can do the same for Mike and Brent and even Danielle's ship. That way you're hiding layers that you don't need to work with at that moment. So as a team, you have decided that you for sure want the explore text and you want this compass image also, but you want a layer of that ship behind the compass image. So what you can do is you can go over into this middle column and you can unlock both of these layers. You're going to move them up to the top now so they have the primary visibility. So that becomes your first and second layer. And then you're going to relock these, which gives you the opportunity now to edit this image further. So as soon as you click on that, your image editing options come up and you're going to click on fill options so you can drop down the transparency of that to about 45% or whatever you would like and exit out of that. And now this layer is finished. And I would just go ahead and unlock that so that you can no longer edit it. Now, what you can do is you can turn the visibility of each of these layers back on to see what Jeff's ship is going to look like under this piece you have already for sure decided on. And you can do this with each of the ships. If you decide that Mike's ship is not a ship that you want to go with, if you come all the way over into this far right column, you can use the delete function to get rid of that ship. And then you can make another ship visible. If Brent's ship isn't the right ship for this flag set, you can delete it also. So now you're going back and forth between Jeff's and Danielle's ship to create the flag that's going to be perfect for your show.